So this is the skull, tamping iron, and life cast of Phineas Gage. Phineas is probably one of the most well-known cases in the history of neuroscience. He was a man who was a foreman on a railroad gang who was going through the process of blowing up large rocks in order to lay down railroad tracks outside of Cavendish, Vermont. He was injured in 1848 when this tamping iron, that's the thing he was packing down the explosive powder with, was shot all the way through his head. Entered into his left cheek, goes behind his left eye, through the left front of his brain, and then out his forehead. He received an injury that should have clearly been fatal, especially in the context of mid-19th century medical science. After the injury, Phineas Gage became obstinate or stubborn. He became vulgar and crass. He swore, which wasn't his custom. And he becomes such a well-known case because he becomes one of the most dramatic examples of post-traumatic personality change or post-traumatic social disinhibition in the sort of scientific literature that gets told throughout the last 150 or so years.